Good evening, everybody. It is May 31st, 2023, and as you can see, the Homer Simpson bass guitar is in the drawing phase. Yeah, awesome. Finally got the neck today, so I had to redraw the drawing. The version I had from before is a little bit smaller, and that would be awesome for a guitar, and I still might do that as a guitar, but for the bass body, I had to make it just a slight tad bigger, and I had to reposition the bridge and everything else to make it look pretty awesome, and I think this is gonna play amazing. I love this neck. As you can see, it's very narrow at the nut, and then it goes awesome. So that's gonna play amazingly. If you didn't know, I was in a band for like 10 years where I played bass and sang. I've been playing guitar for 30 plus years, but we were in a band and the bass player quit. We couldn't find a bass player, so I played bass. I can share a bunch of videos online on YouTube of me playing bass and singing, but that's a whole nother story, but yeah, that's gonna be very cool. Yeah. You know, it's kind of late. It's already like 8 o'clock at night, so I'll have to cut the wood tomorrow. But as far as strings, we're gonna go with the D'Addario XL, and we're gonna go with the 45 to 100 gauge strings. And for the tuners, the machine heads, I chose these ones. These are really cool bass machine heads. They're these ones right here. And as far as I can tell, these seem like they're pretty cool and they're adequate. As far as the bridge, we're gonna go with all the parts here, everything that's gonna go on a guitar. And this pickup, I'm not sure, I'll have to look up exactly, but the K ohms are on it. And of course, we're gonna do the donut and the headstock. So roughly, that's gonna go right about there. And there we go. That's how it's gonna look. I'm gonna make the donut from material. It's gonna be very cool. And that's gonna be Homer chasing the donut. So it's gonna be very cool. Standard bolt-on neck. As far as pedometer goes, we're gonna go with the push-pull pot. And the volume knob, that push pull, and the volume pedometer, very cool. And we're gonna go regular tone with the capacitor. And as far as input jacks, I'm guessing I'll have to cut the wood to find out, make sure. But I'm thinking the input probably gonna be about right there. So I'm guessing that one knee's gonna go here, a knee's gonna fit in this vicinity, and it's gonna be very cool. I'm not really sure of the scale length either. But here's the concept rendering, and as you can see, the donut is going to be right there. Of course, the Raglan logo, Homer on the, it's going to be in that font on the frets, just like that. And that's what the colors are going to be. So it's going to be very cool. And I'll have to figure out the continuity bits as far as the mouth. I'm going to go with three layers of wood like usual. And I might elect to go with this layer, which is the bottom two, and having the top two layers kind of blended in. Same thing with the mouth. I want to make the tongue kind of project outward and just on the top lip, so the tongue is not going to be all the way to the back of the guitar. It's just going to be a top layer, maybe the second layer. And the third layer is just going to be by itself. And then I'll have to figure the continuity bit as far as the teeth. As far as the eye, I'll probably do the side again. And then the reverse image of this, so, you know, with the fingers and everything like that. But that's going to be really cool. Yeah, this pickup I found online, brand new, and it's, I think it's really good. It's going to sound amazing. So we'll see how it goes. This is actually going to be the first bass that I've constructed from scratch. So, I mean, I've been playing bass forever. Owned many basses, but never actually made. And, you know, we've got to do the Homer Simpson bass. And, you know, if you've seen the post from earlier, we're doing the Maggie Simpson guitar, too. So, that's going to be very cool. So, that'll complete the intermediate family, all five of them. So, there we go. Can't wait to get going on this. It's going to be really fun. And thanks for watching and follow me on this journey. It's just gonna be amazing. I can't wait to get everything done and plug it in and see how it plays. I'm sure there's gonna be a lot of challenges to overcome, but you know what, we're gonna do it. So I'm gonna go with the usual strap locks, the Dunlock strap locks. So that's gonna be very cool. All right, and I'm guessing the strap buttons are probably gonna be the usual, like behind the neck plate, on the back of the neck, and then probably like right in the center there. So, all right. Hope everybody's having a good center of the week, Wednesday hump day. And I'm so excited, looking forward to doing this one. So this is gonna be very fun. All right, we will see you soon. The Homer Simpson base is gonna come to life. Love that neck. That neck is just amazing. Got it on Amazon. I think I paid, or eBay actually. I think this neck I got for maybe $42, $45. I think it was $45. So that's not too bad. And I ordered two of them, so I'm gonna do two bases. And I'm thinking about doing a Jabba the Hutt base. Now that would be very cool. I'm messing with some concepts. I'll show you that when I get to that. But having Jabba the Hutt, like he sits. Yeah, but anyway, that's another thing. But yeah, the donut, glazed donut's gonna be colored just like that on the headstock. And of course, he's going nuts for the donuts. Homer's gotta have his donut, so he sees his donut out there and he's going ballistic, so. All right, and we will see you soon. I can't wait, like I said, continue on this one. All right, talk to you later.
All right, June 1st, 2023. Continue work on the Homer Simpson electric guitar bass, and we're gonna go ahead and cut up, and we'll see when you get that done. All right, very cool. Got the cut out. It's looking pretty amazing. That is gonna be one kick butt bass. All right, so let me go outside and configure some wood, and then we'll get the wood together. We'll see in a little bit. Alright, got a piece of wood out, and it looks like we're going to go with 19 and a half inches, three pieces of 19 and a half, and this is a half inch plywood, and I think the center layer will probably be 3/4 inch plywood, so it'll have two half inch, one on top, one on the bottom, and then the middle being the 3/4, and that should give it enough girth and weight to support the base. So, alright, let me get this figured out, and we'll see in a bit. Alright, got my three pieces cut out perfectly, and it looks pretty cool. And if you're wondering of the thickness, it's about the thickness of a Stratocaster body. So it'll be cool once I sand it and everything. It might take a little bit off as far as width goes. But all right, so what I'm gonna do now is figure out my template. It's a little bit windy today. Get my template out, figure out where I can temporarily fasten these three pieces together with something that they're not in the way, the temporary fastening. And then we'll get the scroll saw queued up, and then we'll cut out the shape. Alright, we'll see you in a little bit. Ooh, windy. This time around, actually, before I fasten the three pieces together, I'm going to go ahead and draw out the lines. I got the shape taped to the wood. I'm going to go ahead and get my pencil line around so I can figure out, and then I'll figure out where to place these strategically. I'm guessing like one right there, not in the way. Probably one there, the two there, one up here in the head maybe, and then maybe one down here, just before I cut the wood. Alright, we'll see if I can get the trace out. Alright, very cool, got the shape traced out on the wood. As you can see, silhouette of Homer chasing that donut. Alright, so let's say we've got some temporary screws. Let's say temporarily fix, let me look at my... It's been windy. I want my template flying away on me. Oop. I don't want to shred it to pieces either. I'm going to need it for tracing. Let's see where the bridge is going to be. The bridge is going to be there. So let's... the pickup's going to be there. So tell you what, let's figure this out and I'll be right back. Alright, got the pattern, or the screws temporarily fixing all three pieces together, which is awesome. I got my newly modified, let me show you the modification I did, just a new claw on both sides to hold the blade. and I got it fixed to the surface, so we shouldn't get any movement. Fingers crossed this goes smooth. All right, got plenty of blades. Let's start slowly but carefully cutting out the shape, and we'll see in a bit. All right, very cool. Cut out the shape. It's looking pretty awesome. And I think it weighs enough that I don't think there'll be any kind of neck dive, because I was worried about it weighing enough, because the neck is not heavy, but it's got some girth to it. But yeah, very cool. All right, I got my carbon paper, and I'll get my template, and I'll trace the shapes on the top of the wood copy, and I'll be right back. All right, got the shapes traced out. It looks pretty killer. And I've got some really cool ideas. I was thinking about the continuity bits. You know, I like to do all the continuity as far as the front and the back. Let's see if I can explain this correctly. All right, it's three layers. I've got three layers of wood. And what I plan on doing is, see where I've got it marked? That's gonna be the top layer. And then the back layer is not gonna have that. It's gonna have the mouth. So it's gonna go like this. The mouth is still gonna be there, but I'm going to cut the teeth just on the top layer of wood. And this center section is gonna be halfway, but I'm going to cut out on just the top layer alone the shape of the mouth and the tongue. So I'm going to cut here, around the tongue, and the tongue's gonna stay on the top layer. And this little section right here, I'm gonna dremel out to where it kind of joins this layer. This layer, this part of the mouth, is just gonna be half of the layer. So it's gonna be a little bit raised from this black part that's gonna be the mouth. And like I said, the teeth is just gonna be on the top layer. The teeth's not gonna go through the second and the third layers. So it's gonna give it a real cool 3D effect. And I might do half a layer on this part and this part. And my original design idea was to have this on the second and third layer and take it on the first layer, but seeing how the bridge comes far back, we're just going to leave that flush with the top. But I'll figure out the continuity bits on that when I get to it. But yeah, okay, so thinking, maybe I should do that. See, the top two layers, they can be connected. They don't have to be separated at this point. Because, well, first let me cut out the neck pocket first. We'll cut out the neck pocket, and then we'll get the neck dialed in perfectly with the neck tendon, and then we'll do the continuity bits. That way, we can glue, once we cut that out, then we can glue the top layers together after I cut out the continuity bits, like I'm explaining, and have that extra piece and everything. But let's go ahead and get the neck and cut the neck pocket out, and then get that dialed in with the bridge, and then we'll see you next step. Yeah, we'll get that done. But yeah, it's looking pretty cool so far. It's gonna be a really cool base. All right, we'll see you in a bit. All right, just got the neck dry fitted and where it's gonna go and where the bridge is gonna theoretically go. And it looks pretty cool. And it's starting to cloud up, and I just felt a drop of rain, so that really sucks. It's coming, or it just looks just like a, maybe it'll blow over. Hopefully it'll blow over. I'm gonna show you how it's gonna look, so that's very cool. All right, so let me separate the three layers, just get the top two layers, and then cut out for the neck pocket, and weather permitting. All right, we'll see you in a little bit. I think I got the neck pocket dialed in. Really didn't have to shim anything on just the bottom two layers. It's bass, it's a little different than the guitar, but I think I am gonna countersink the neck plate in the back, which will give it a really cool effect. But yeah, let me glue in the tendon, because I did cut the tendon. Let's see if I can do this one-handed. So let me glue in the second layer, and then we'll get ready and countersink the bolt, the neck plate, and then we'll get that done. We'll see you in a little bit. All right, quick update. Got the neck plate, and I'm going to countersink the neck plate, and I'm going to leave a little bit of room on either side. As you can see, I've got fresh X-Acto blade, and I scored it. Got my Dremel bit, and I'm going to go ahead and I didn't mount the tendon yet because I want to install the neck first to see how everything flows. I might install it prior to that, but it's going to be a really strong neck joint because it's going to have to be because of the base strings. But once I score that out, it's going to be flush. So you see how it's going to give it a really cool effect. Fingers crossed, I have a steady hand and I'm able to do this. All right, we'll see you on the other side. All right, successful countersink of the neck plate. Let me show you what I mean. See, I took it down so that way it's going to be countersunk. And do this with one hand, it's real tight, but that's perfect. So that way it's almost flush and it gives it a really cool look. And it gives the screws a little bit more depth to dig into the neck because, it's kind of thick. All right, so let me turn around and get all the pieces temporarily fastened together. And let's go ahead and install his neck, clean up my mess, of course. Install the neck, I'll be right back. All right, got the neck installed. And it's looking pretty killer. And it feels really balanced. And it's just awesome. And I think there's definitely going to be a very strong neck joint. And I like how I countersinked it. That is going to be amazing. Can't wait to get all the continuity bits and everything like that. But yeah, I'm going to do a string test. Make sure I don't have to... and I didn't glue in the tendon just yet because just in case I have to adjust, I want to make sure. So gonna go ahead and actually install the strap buttons. That way I see how it hangs on the body. But let me show you in the lap how it sits. Let me turn the camera around. I'll be right back. All right. Let's see, it's right there. Let me see if I can get the camera. Whoa. A little closer. Bring the camera, but yeah, it sits perfect in your lap, and the base line is right here. Let's see if I can get this closer. Uh-oh, wind is gonna take my stuff. All right, let's see if it fits. Let me show you. You got one knee there, and then you got one knee there. Very cool, and it's perfectly balanced. And that way, and let's see, put on the strap, but bridge line right there, it's hard to see, but yeah, we can definitely have plenty of playability and room, and you can theoretically get to the higher registers, not that you'll ever need that, but you can definitely get to the higher notes if you want to do some Cliff Burton bass playing. But let me go ahead and get the strap buttons installed. Let me turn the camera on. All right. Theoretically, as per usual, we're going to try to put a strap button right there, right in the center of the neck plate, and then we'll go right in the center line on the back heel here. We'll see how that works, and let's see if it hangs proper. All right, let me get that done, and I'll be right back. All right, got the strap buttons installed. I got my strap, and let's see how we did. What do you think? You think we got it right the first time? I hope so. I think so. All right, we'll see you in a little bit. All right, what do you think? How do you think we did? We nailed it. What do you think of that? And the base line, the bridge line is right there. So, let's see. Let's turn the camera. Plenty of room. So, boom. Right there. What do you think of that? Is that cool or what? Gonna be like... A little bit of air bass, a little bit of Cliff Burton. Very cool. Played with a pick when I play bass. I mean, I use my fingers on some of the slower stuff, but I always... But that is very cool. Imagine a guitar player having the Bart Simpson or the Marge Simpson, and then somebody playing the Homer bass. All right, next step is going to be to go ahead and get the bridge installed and do the string test. But yeah, That's pretty cool. No neck dive at all. If it's right and it doesn't go forward, I think it's going to be such an amazing playing bass. Very cool. Alright, we'll see you in a bit.
Alright, got the bridge in the correct position. My intonation line is right there, and I gave plenty of room. Fingers crossed on this. I can always readjust it later when we do a string test if it's off, but there should be plenty of intonation either way. And I pre-marked, it's actually six holes. And I got the proper drill bit marked and my screws. Let me go ahead and install the bridge and I'll be right back. All right, okay, I went ahead and installed the bridge. And I did a string test, and it's perfectly straight, and the line for the action is perfect. I think they have plenty of room, and I can always shim and readjust the bridge, but yeah, it's pretty awesome. All right, next step is going to be to get the pickup out and then mark out where the pickup cavity is going to go, but we're getting a lot done. It looks pretty awesome. All right, I'll see you in a little bit. All right, got where the pickup is going to go. Very cool. And I marked out the line exactly where it's gonna go. So we're gonna go ahead and cut that out. And I did a string test, and I'll check again just to make sure that the poles, you know, the strings line up. A string test to make sure that the strings are over the pole pieces, which it should be, before I actually cut it out. But yeah, pretty killer. That pickup's gonna be awesome, so. And then before I separate any layers, I'll go ahead and mark out where the pedometers are going to go. That'll be the next step, and then I'll drill through all pieces, but we'll see in a bit. Alright, drill through all pieces where the volume and the tone is going to go. And I checked it as far as the bridge, and it's in the perfect spot to reach and grab. But yeah, I think it might actually start to rain. It's clouding up, so this will probably conclude progress for today. Got a lot done. It's already like 4 o'clock in the afternoon, so I don't know if I'll have time before it gets dark later. Yeah, it's really cloudy up there, so. Alright, did get a lot done today. It's going to be so wicked. Oh, can't wait. Alright, hope everybody's having a good center of the week, and we'll see you in a bit.
Alright, before it starts raining, I actually wanted to show one more time with the bridge. Very cool. Put the donut on the headstock, it's gonna be very cool. All right. Everybody's having a good one, see ya.
Good morning, everybody. It's 2nd of June. I can't get familiar with June. June 2023, it's time to continue work on the Homer Simpson bass electric guitar. And I got some really cool stuff planned for today. Gonna do some continuity bits, some really cool things that I have a good idea for. Gonna do some countersinking of some stuff. Gonna do what I mentioned yesterday with the mouth. Countersink this a little bit, except for where the bridge is gonna go. Countersink the foot there, and on the back, the arm this way. And we'll see. We're gonna do a bunch of good stuff. All right, so let's figure out. Probably gonna cut out this section here first today. So let me get set up and I'll see you in a bit. All right, I got three pieces separated. Let me cut out the mouth bits like I explained a little bit yesterday. And it's gonna be really cool, a 3D section, get that worked out, and we'll see you in a bit. All right, here's the idea. I cut out the bit, and I've got the little mouth bit, and I cut the second and third layer with the minus the teeth. So let me show you what I had. What I was thinking, and I think this is going to turn out real cool. And this bit right here is the mouth bit, but I'm going to cut it in half, so it's going to hang in there in half. And I'm going to get the Dremel out. All right, now I hope I make sense when I say this. I'm going to Dremel down the teeth one layer, so probably about a centimeter or so. I'm going to Dremel down this section about halfway, two layers. Okay, I'm going to Dremel down the foot halfway of the top layer, so that's about two layers. And then I'm gonna try to Dremel down, with the exception of where the bridge is gonna go, I'm gonna leave that flush. So I'm gonna mark out where that's gonna go, and that's gonna Dremel down.
And then on the reverse image, I'm gonna do the back of this hand, and I'm gonna leave the rest of it flat. Cause I could have done like the reverse image of his leg going the other way. And then, but now I think the continuity will be fine. And then once I do that layer, I'll take down these two nubs down even a third layer. So it'll be just one layer. But first off, I'm gonna glue the second and third layer together, cause we need them together, you know, glued together so that I can do all the Dremel bits. And then when I cut out for the pickup opening. So let me go ahead and glue these two sections together and we'll be back in a little bit. Alright, completed the part that I was talking about with the mouth. Let me show you. And I'll perfect underneath, of course. But you see how I did the lip and did the tongue, and then I carved the tongue. That way it's very 3D. And as far as the teeth are concerned, on the back side. See how the teeth and the tongue only are on the top layer, so that's really cool. That is awesome. And I'm gonna countersink the eyes like always, except for leaving the pupils raised, you know, to this, you know, flush with the rest of the body, and that lower, and then I'll Dremel. And I had another cool idea too with the, as far as the hair, I was thinking about painting, you know, bending a coat hanger wire exactly where it needs to go in the exact shape, same thing with here and around the back, and then spray painting that black, making that the hair. So that's going to be really cool. So let me go ahead and Dremel the parts that I want to lower a little bit. Like I'll do the arm here, do the leg, and then this section minus the bridge, I'll leave that flush, the bridge. And so let me do that and let me get that working on. But yeah, that turned out really cool. And when it's painted, it's gonna look just so awesome. And of course, it can be black, and then the skin tone, the tan of the mouth and everything. So it's gonna look good. All right, we'll see in a little bit. All right, quick update. I Dremeled out the eyes. I left the pupils flush, and then I'll make sure they're the same shape and size and everything. I'll get that dialed in. But yeah, it's looking pretty cool. All right, so now I'm gonna tackle the other bits. And I drilled out where the bridge is gonna go, so let me go knock that out and I'll bring it back. And also I'm gonna Dremel all the individual lines. This is really cool. Alright, see that. Alright, quick update, very cool. I got all the bits Dremeled and it's looking pretty awesome, and I countersunk the bits I told you that I was gonna do with the, you know, even lower with the fingers, and then low there with that, and then of course the eyes. And then all the Dremel bits. Looks pretty awesome. Yeah, that looks pretty cool. And all Dremeled except for where the bridge is gonna sit. So that's gonna be pretty cool. It's gonna give it a good look when it's all painted. All right, so now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go ahead and cut out for the pickup cavity through the top two layers. So we'll get that worked out. And then when I'm gonna get that done, I'll get back to you. See you in a bit. All right, perfect cutout for the pickup. It's perfect size. It looks pretty awesome. Alright, let me figure out what the next step's going to be to turn it over and start figuring out the wiring. Alright, let's see in a little bit. Alright, wiring's pretty straightforward. Just a push-pull pot, the tone knob, and then the input jack. So, I got the Dremel tool out, so let's go ahead and cut this out and get these installed. See you in a bit. Alright, quick update. Perfectly cut out for the wiring, input jack, pedometers, the battery, and then on the back plate for the access panel. So we're ready for the glue phase. We're ready to glue these two pieces, they're all pieces together, the top and the bottom. All right, we'll get that done and we'll see in a little bit. All right, successfully glued everything together. We are one solid body. It's looking pretty cool. Got a lot of Bondo filler to fill on the sides, but yeah. And then started figuring out some of the back bits. I'm not sure about that. I'll have to figure it out exactly, but very cool. All the wiring is done. Pretty killer. Alright, hope everybody's having a good day near the weekend. And we'll continue with this tomorrow, the next day. And we will see. Good morning. June 4th, 2023, beautiful sunny day here in South Florida. It's Time to continue work on the Homer Simpson electric bass. And I think I've decided I'm gonna go a little bit lower on some of these recess bits. Like go lower on this section here. Maybe go lower from like gradual there. And make that a little bit lower, and same thing with the foot. So we'll work on that first thing, and then we'll flip it over and figure out the back bits. But yeah, and then we'll do some Bondo on the sides, fill in all the voids that necessary, and then start working it, start putting the edge on everything, and then get everything ready, and then maybe even do a string test later on today. We'll see how far we get, so that'd be pretty cool. But all right, we'll see in a little bit. All right, another quick update. Oh, that is cool as hell. I lowered this section here and then emphasized a little bit lower on the tips. So you can see how that turned out. That turned out really wickedly. And then I lowered this section and then lowered the appropriate fingers. So that looks pretty cool. So I'll just show you how it turned out. Definitely gives it that whole 3D stereo look. Of course, I'll, you know, refine all the lines once I get it dialed in the way I like it. Now, on this hand, I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna go ahead and Dremel off probably about a quarter inch or so, and then leave this one flush, of course, and then figure out the back bits. But yeah, it's coming along pretty good. All right, we'll see in a little bit. All right, I figured out the back bits, and I think this should be good. It doesn't have to be 100% precise because it's in the back, but it does look pretty cool that way. I might adjust this hand a little, just a little bit. But yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and get my Dremel and get the appropriate bit, and then countersink those parts, and then find any continuity bits. Like the side is a 5 o'clock shadow, and the eye bit, work all that out, and then we'll do some body filler on the sides and anywhere that needs it. I did the holes, and I gotta do a couple holes that there, but I think overall it's pretty cool. I did the Dremel bits on that part. So let me go ahead and do the back. It's looking pretty cool. So, all right, so let me get that going and I'll see you in a minute. All right, I went ahead and cut out all the parts. It looks pretty cool. All right, next step is gonna be to get the Bondo filler and do all the, you know, fill in all the voids on the sides and wherever it needs it. Started to on the back already, but kind of like that. So let me go ahead and start working on that and I'll see you in a bit. Real quick, I'm going to make and install the back access panel for the pedometers. I'm going to use some free-ply material. I'm going to paint it anyway. So I'm going to go ahead and make a shape, cut it out, countersink it, and install it. And we'll see in a little bit. Alright, back access panel plate installed and countersunk with the screws countersunk as well. Alright, so let me go ahead and start with the ugly face part one and do all the body filler along the sides and everywhere it needs it. Alright, we'll see in a bit. Alright, quick update. Ugly face part one is in full effect. I got all the body filler in all the appropriate spots. I got my files, getting ready to go ahead and make everything nice and flush and awesome. So, and then round the edges where it needs to be. It's probably gonna take a little while, but yeah, it's looking pretty cool. All right, we'll see you when I get some progress done. See you in a minute. All right, this will conclude progress today on the body of the Homer Simpson electric guitar bass build. And I think today's progress turned out really good. As you recall, we're done with the ugly face part one. Did all the body filler on the sides and anywhere else that needed it. And I just wanted to show you. Give you the full view of today's progress, and I rounded all the body part bits and really cool. And I'll perfect some of this, and I've got to do some continuity lines with the eye just a little bit there. But I just wanted to call it for today. I'm getting kind of tired, and I haven't glued in the neck tendon yet. When I do the string test and I see that that's the proper height, because I'm not sure. Never, you know, first time doing a bass, and I just want to make sure before I commit to the depth of the bass tendon. Once I glue that in, that'll be completely supported, and it'll be just so strong and durable. So
Yeah, but let me show you how the back turned out. Take out the next template. Yeah, really cool with the etchings. And everything's really cool with the hand. And I did that hand, I countersunk that hand, and it looks pretty cool. But yeah, can't wait to do the little donut bit on the headstock. Next step is going to be probably tomorrow, do all the fret work, level ground and polish on the frets, and then start working on the donut on the headstock bit. And that's going to be really cool. Yeah, that pickup is going to be amazing. I've seen some really good things written about that pickup, so it's going to be good. And then with the tone and the volume, the push-pull pot, it'll be able to coil split on the pickup. It's just going to be awesome. But all right, hope everybody's having a good weekend. And I love the continuity bits with the mouth. That turned out really cool. When that's painted, that's just going to look so amazing. And when the flesh tones and the white and the blue. And I love that the bridge is looks like it's on the platform a little bit. That's cool. But that's going to be painted blue as well. So, and then the white for the shirt. And gray for the shoes. And, of course, yellow flesh tones. Black for the mouth. White for the teeth. Red for the tongue. Black for the pupils. You know, all the good stuff. But, yeah, see, that just turned out so cool. I love the, and it's a little shallower towards the end of the hand. And this, I wanted to make it a little bit meatier that way. So that's cool. Same thing with the back is a little bit shallower if you look. But, yeah, that's really cool. All right. And we will talk to you soon. Good morning, everybody. The 5th of June. And as you can see, it's time to continue work on the Homer Simpson electric bass guitar. Necks is, oh, I love this, and these necks are pretty awesome. I actually bought two of them, but feeding time for the dogs. But anyway, so we're gonna do some fret work today. We're gonna do the donut on the top of the headstock, so we're gonna, and then we're gonna try to do a sound test. So let's see if we can get done today. It's early, it's like 9 in the morning, so go through the usual stuff that I always do for the guitar necks. So at first we'll start off straight in the neck, then we'll see how the edge, yeah, I'm going to have to put a better edge on the frets, and then we'll see in a little bit. A quick update, I had my fret end file, and I made all the frets nice and rounded, and they feel awesome, alright, and took my guitar straight edge, and you actually have to use it a little bit further down from like the 7th fret. But the neck appears to be completely straight. I'm going to go through with my rocker arm and check and see how bad the frets are. But we're going to tape up the frets and put a level crown and polish on the frets. And we'll see you next step. Alright, quick update. Got all the frets taped up. And we are good to go. Got a fresh 320 grit sandpaper on my leveling beam. And the neck is completely straight. But I wanted to show you how bad the frets were. Not extremely horrible. Let's see if I can do this one arm. Watch this. Let's see if I can do this. See that rock? That is a major high fret on the 2nd fret. Let's see if I can. Yeah, see that? See how much movement there is? And then that one's pretty good. But then you go to the next fret. And there's also movement, not as much as that first fret, but that fret is pretty high. But when I level that, let's check some other ones. That one's not too bad. Yeah, there's some movement there. See, it's, see that? You put it on the 3 frets, and if you feel movement, that means you hear it. Got a high fret. And let's see how far up. It's not too bad. Yeah, that, you look at how bad that one is. Wow, we got some major high frets. But luckily, these frets are pretty tall. But I'll be taking off some material. So, fingers crossed, we don't take off too much. But I'm going to go ahead and mark all the frets with my black felt tip. And as per usual, I always like to make it flat on the ends when I mark them. And we're going to put a level on these frets. And fingers crossed it goes well. We have another neck as a backup just in case, but you know, this shouldn't be too bad, but we'll see how it goes. All right, see you in a bit.
All right, we are level. I did have to take off quite a bit of material on certain frets. As you can see, let's see, like that one, and of course that one, but I think we should be good to go. All right, so let me remark it and put a crown on these frets, and we'll see in a bit.
All right, quick update. I got all the frets leveled and crowned, and I wanted to show you how they look before I round them over and put a nice polish on the frets. Looking pretty sweet. As you can see, all the fret lines are pretty consistent. Pretty awesome. All right, and as usual, we're gonna go through the usual grits of sandpaper from 800. We got 800, 1000, 1200, 1500, 2000, 2500, 3000, 5000, 7000, all the way up to 10,000 grits. So, all right, so let me start the long, arduous process of putting a round edge on the frets. So let me show you what they look like prior to this step. And make them beautiful. All right, this neck should play. This bass should play amazingly. All right, we'll see you in a bit. All right, another quick update. All the frets have been leveled, crowned, and polished. And let me show you the end result. The frets look amazing. I love this part. All right, so let me remove the tape and you know, clean up all my fret dust and clean up my mess and get everything going. So let me do that and I'll see you back in a sec. But yeah, those frets look brilliant. They look great. Oh yeah. All right, see you in a little bit. All right, another quick update. Frets have been level crowned and polished, and they are looking beautiful, amazing. Yeah, I always love that step. And I did the fret end edges, and man, they just feel and play amazing. Well, play, I mean, they feel. I haven't played it yet, but they're gonna play amazing. All right. So next step is to my favorite part. Gonna be, I'm gonna work on the donuts. So I'm gonna get my template out, and we're gonna cut some material, and then we're gonna, you know, get the donut going. All right, so let me figure out what the next step's gonna be. I'm gonna be right back. All right, got the cutout for the donut bit, and I like the teeth mark. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna trace this out on the neck where exactly it's gonna go. Then I'm gonna get some extra pickguard material that I, or a headstock material that I have, and then cut that out. And then I'm thinking about going for the icing layer to go with another layer, another thin layer on top of the base layer, but I'll show you that when I get to that. So let me go ahead and start working this and I'll be right back. All right, got my donut piece cut out where it's gonna fit on the headstock, just like that. Perfect. And I cut out where I'm gonna cut out on the neck, the headstock. I've got me a piece of wood and I'm gonna go ahead and trace this out. Then I'm gonna get out the scroll saw and carefully cut this piece out. All right, we'll see you when I get some progress done. All right, got my shape traced out in the wood. Looks pretty good. And I got my scroll saw, which I bought a brand new scroll saw. I'll have to show you that. Brand new scroll saw, minus the light. This light kind of went out like third or fourth week I've had it. So, but this one's still working, so we'll keep using this one until it completely dies. So, all right, let me cut this out carefully at the wood and we'll see you in a bit. Got the shape cut out. It looks pretty awesome. Got the donut. And I haven't glued it in yet, but I'm gonna glue it. And I purposely chose this particular size wood because it's a little bit fatter than the actual headstock material. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get my tuning keys out. I'm gonna make sure the washer sits in there, and I'm gonna fill it in with body filler. And then I might do another layer, and I think some plastic, some thinner plastic. I think I've got some similar, even like pickguard material. That's a little, and then make the frosting out of that to cover it. It's gonna look really cool. But let me show you that. Let me glue this in. Got my tuning keys and my Bondo over there, and let's get this worked out. All right, see you in a bit. All right, very cool. Got the donut cut out.
and that looks awesome. And I specifically chose this wood because it's a little bit thicker than the headstock material itself, but I'm gonna have the back be flush and I'm gonna fill in with body filler on the top here to connect that. So that's gonna be really cool. And then the icing is gonna get a separate, might go with plastic, and then paint the plastic the correct color, because that way I can shape the plastic the way that I need and then glue that to the actual. I came across a fixable snag. And because of my experience, it's an easy fix. Well, you know, okay fix. I discovered that the tuning keys that I picked, for some reason the holes in the neck are way bigger. So let me show you. So definitely way bigger, but it's an easy fix from my experience with Bondo and such. Luckily I've got a pen here that I'm going to fill in the hole as such, and I'm gonna put some Bondo body filler, and I'm gonna put some Vaseline on this right here so it doesn't stick to it, and I'm gonna put it in there and it's gonna set, and I'm gonna sand it, and I'm gonna paint the white face, the face of the headstock white, and also the back of the headstock white with the exception of the donut. The donut, I'm gonna paint the donut color. So I'll do all that first and then I'll fill it in, and then I'll make a little bit of a bigger, I'll find a bigger, I'm gonna do some paper or cardboard. I'll show you that step when I get to it, but let me get this taken care of real quick and I'll see you in a bit. Okay, got my jig constructed. Let me fill in the body filler and I'll see you when I'm done with that. All right, very cool. First layer of body filler has been applied. And you know what? I'm really digging the body filler. I mean, I'll sand it and smooth it out a little bit more than that, but I'm kind of digging the texture of it. I might just go with the frosting with that, because initially my first thought was going to be to have like a piece of, you know, something like one-ply pickguard material and then paint it the color of the frosting, which is going to be like a pinkish color, and the donut's going to be like a tan color. But I'm actually liking the texture of the Bondo filler, so I might actually just apply that around and then trim it accordingly to where the frosting ends and have that as the frosting, because that looks really cool. And then around the edges there, the back, sand it more perfect than that. Yeah, so I think I'll do that. I'll just work that. So, and then I'll still do the sprinkles with some sort of other thing. But yeah, the tuning keys, I gotta do the other three tuning keys with the smaller hole. But yeah, let me apply some body filler and I'll see you in a little bit. Graphic update, very cool. I applied some more body filler and I'll perfect it, of course. Make it smooth, make it look close to frosting as possible. In the back, I'm gonna, like I said, paint white, and then the whatever the donut color, and then the frosting will be that pink color. Yeah, let me go ahead and install the rest of the tuning keys, so, you know, make the shrink the holes with the process, and then that's pretty cool. Then we're almost ready for a string test once I get that done. And I got certain string trees. I'll probably put a string tree between the E and the B string. I don't know, probably somewhere in that vicinity or something, but that looks cool. With the bite marks and everything. Alright, we'll see in a little bit. Alright, very cool. Got it all cleaned up, and I filled in the holes, made them smaller, but yeah, that looks pretty cool. And of course, I'll sand and make perfect and everything like that. Yeah, this is just the beginning. But yeah, that looks pretty cool. Alright, so let me install the tuning keys, and I'll see you in a little bit. Alright, very cool. Got the tuning keys installed. Looking pretty sweet. Alright, so let's get the body out here. And I've got some cool... for the hair, I got me a black hanger. So let me try to work that out real quick. I'll be right back. All right, really cool for the hair. Here's the coat hanger I was talking about, black hanger. And I'm going to bend it in the shape of the hair, boom, boom, and then around the side, and to that side, and then two loop-de-loops, and then drill holes for that. I'll see you in a little bit. All right, I got a piece cut. And I want to show you, I'm going to drill a hole going angled that way and then mount it right in the front here and then do a second one. So we'll see in a little bit. Very cool. Alright, completed the hair on the top of the head. And that looks just so cool. Let's get like a different light here. Very cool. So cool. Alright, now time to work on this piece right here. And it's gonna bend around the back and then come around on this side where the other ear. Oh, you know what? Come to think of it, I forgot the other, or did I? Yeah, I forgot the other. Well, there's an ear there, but there should be an ear here. Yeah, I have to go find out where I'm gonna put the ear. Yeah, there you go. You find stuff like that. So, all right, we'll see in a little bit. All right, drew in the other ear, and then I'll Dremel that bit, but let me figure out the hairline. It's gonna be like jagged, so all right, we'll see in a bit. All right, did the side hair bit. I think it turned out good, and I'll have to glue it in once the paint and everything like that, so it doesn't come out. So that way, and in order to get it in and out of there, I have to kind of bend it, but I'll glue it. But that looks cool. And I decided not to do, well, I still can do some, yeah. Let me try to do one around the back. Because he does have a hairline that goes doop, 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 doop. Let me do one, a separate one around the back. So let me get that done. See in a little bit. Really cool though. All right, got the back hair bit and the ear countersunk. That looks very cool. All right. Oh wow, that is cool. That was a cool idea. It's a cool touch. And of course, I'll glue these in when they're ready to go in permanent, of course. But yeah, that looks pretty cool. Alright, let me clean up my mess and let's attach the nap. Let's go for a string test. It's already like 4:30. I've been at it since like 9:30, 10 o'clock this morning already. So, oh yeah, we got a lot done though. Look at that. That is so cool. We'll see in a little bit. Alright, perfect. I love that hair bit. Alright, let's go ahead and reinstall the bridge. But yeah, that just makes it, especially when it's colored, it's just gonna look amazing. We'll see in a little bit. Alright, reattach the bridge. It's looking pretty good. Let me go ahead and reattach the neck and we'll be right back. Very cool. Alright, got the neck out. Dog's feeding time. Let me go ahead and attach the neck and then we'll figure out if I'm going to glue the neck pocket in or the neck tendon. So, alright, got the neck attached. And wow, look at that. That is so cool. I have never seen such a cool base. That is just so cool. Somebody took a bite out of that donut too. That is just so cool. That's wicked. Oh man. Look at that. That is so cool. That is so fun. Oh man. And it'll stand by itself too. Wow. That's cool. Alright, let me put some strings on here and see how we did as far as lining everything up. Very cool. Alright, and we'll see in a little bit. Fingers crossed. Alright, got the E and the G string on. It's looking just awesome. Cool, man. I am gonna start making a lot more basses. So, all right, let me get the other two strings on there and we'll see in a little bit. All right, got all four strings on there. Looks pretty good. I am gonna have to shift the neck a little bit because it did wander just a little bit to the left, but that's not a problem. I compensate for this. All I gotta do is when I loosen the neck a little bit, just push it just a hair to the right and it'll straighten the strings. So, and let me go ahead and put the string tree on there. But yeah, I'm just gonna use one string tree between, it's gonna go right about there. And it's gonna go between the D and the G string. So let me go ahead and get that going and I'll be right back. But very cool. All right, successful installation of the string tree. Looks pretty good. And I shifted the neck over and now we're right dead center. So that's perfect. So let me go ahead and install the strap buttons, and then we can go ahead and do a string test. I do believe might have to shim the neck when it's all said and done. I'm not really sure yet. We'll see how it goes. All right, install the string trees, be right back, or the strap buttons, be right back.
All right, I just want to do a quick sound test. I'll do a more thorough one in a little bit after it settles, but I just wanted to show you how it turned out. Looks very cool. See if I can remember any songs. Like I said before, I played bass and sang in a band for many, many years, but it's been like so long since I played any of those songs. So, but I just wanted to show you how it looks. Cumbersome, I think I remember that one. If the battery dies and this video cuts out, I'll do another one when I charge the battery. I have become I think I remember Gotta Get Away From You by The Offspring. My battery's getting ready to die any second. Strings are stretching, but yeah, it feels pretty good. And I've got to cut the nut. The nut is way high. But it hangs perfect. No neck dive at all. And it looks really killer. That headstock is just something else. Yeah. Battery's gonna die here any second now, so let me wrap this up for right now. And I'll do another full sound demonstration. But yeah, that is just wicked. That's cool. And let's see if I could show you real quick where it sits when you sit. Yeah, right there. So that's pretty cool. And you can definitely hit the highest note. I think once I cut the nut slots, it's gonna play so amazing. My little hair bit I knocked off. Yeah, when I glue these things on there, after the paint is already done, then they're not gonna come out at all. But right now they're just temporary in there. But yeah. And when this neck settles and everything like that, then I'll readjust all the action and do a full sound demonstration. But yeah, that's pretty wicked cool. But the battery's gonna die, so all right, hope everybody's having a good day. And we will see you when I charge the battery and get everything dialed in. But very cool. I'll show you the back of that stock. Pretty cool. He's chasing after that donut. Oh, Homer's gotta get to the donut. We'll see you later. See you in a little bit. Alright, how's everybody doing? Good afternoon, June 6, 2023. It's time to continue work on the Homer Simpson electric space. It's had a day to stretch or shift or settle any way it wanted to, and it really didn't settle at all. It's like perfectly good. I cut the nut slots perfectly, so the action and playability is just amazing. Let me show you that. So usually you grab it on the third fret, and you want minimal. I could go lower, but I think this is good. It plays really comfortable. It's completely, the neck's completely straight, and as you can see, the action is really low, so it plays amazingly. Now I'm ready to get some paint on this guitar. I could let it settle for another day or two, but I mean, I'll get it dialed in. So let me go ahead and disassemble the guitar. I'm gonna actually fix this nut or this slot here a little bit better, make it a little bit prettier, and I'm actually gonna install the pickup. With the pickup springs and everything like that before paint. Usually I did this step after the paint, but I think I'm going to do this real quick, knock that out, and then we'll go to the ugly phase part two. We'll get some wood grain filler and everything like that and start prepping this body for paint. I can't wait to get this guitar completely finished and plugged in and have it come through the amp. It's been hot here in Central Florida, I tell you what. Gotta run the air conditioning, but yeah, I can't wait to get some paint on here. That's gonna sound amazing with the coil split and the dome knob. All right, so let me get it completely disassembled and we'll see you in a little bit. All right, quick update. I corrected the angle, put in some body metal, looks pretty good. Got the pickup out, wire fished through, and I got the really good springs and the screws. And I determined that I want the pickup to come up a little further on the neck. So I've cut three nubs. I'm gonna get glue in place, put a center hole, and then mount the pickup, and I'll be back in a while. All right, got the pickup perfectly installed. And as you can see, there's room for up and down in the spring, so it's mounted perfectly. It's completely flush and square. All right, so. Got that done. All right, and I'll clean up my little bit of a mess, and we can start with the ugly phase part two. We can mix up some wood grain filler, and man, get the painting process started. I'll see you in a bit. All right, got to pick up out. Just want to show you real quick how the nubs look. Perfect. All right, we'll see you in a second. All right, first layers have been applied. Ugly phase part two in full effect. Already done the back and the sides, so. Looking like it should. Alright. We'll see when I put some more layers on there. Good morning, everybody. It is June 7th, 2023. It's time to continue to work on the Homer Simpson guitar. Yesterday I applied all the layers of wood grain filler, and we are looking pretty ugly, as perfectly ugly, just like ugly as it should look. So, alright, like I said, I'll let this dry overnight, so we're good to go. Let me show you the very rough texture. So we're going to get everything set up for outside, and we're going to go ahead and sand this smooth,
and make it beautiful. And then we're gonna do some primer coats today. Maybe put it on a hanger, do some primer coats, and then we'll be good to go. Then we can work on the neck a little bit, maybe do a headstock. But all right, let me get everything set up outside, and we'll see in a little bit. All right, got everything outside, and as usual, we'll start on the back and the sides, and then we'll go around to the front. But I got all my materials here, all my sanding equipment and files. So let's go ahead and make this guitar bass guitar beautiful. All right, we'll see when I get some progress there. All right, ugly phase part two has been completed, and we are ready to put it on the hanger and apply some primer base coats of paint. Just wanted to show you how good it turned out. Let me get it on the hanger and I'll do a better visual. It's kind of in shadows here, but looks pretty cool. All the continuity bits. Alright, let me put it on the hanger and I'll be back in a bit. Alright, got it on the hanger. It's looking pretty good. And next step, like I said, some primer coats. And I'm glad I did that step before the paint. Very cool. Alright, we'll see when I get some paint on there. Fingers crossed. I'll show you all the continuity bits. Very cool. See you in a bit. Alright, a quick update. The primer filler has been completed and it's looking pretty good. I mean, I'll have to sand. I planned on sanding anyway. So this layer of primer I'm gonna sand, make flat, and then might go with another layer of primer just to make it completely perfect. But yeah, as you can see, gonna need to sand these bits, but that's part of it. The primer gets into the pores where the grooves were, like under the bridge. It doesn't matter because it's gonna be covered. But once this dries real hard, I'll sand it really flat and it'll look pretty sweet. And I can elect to go with another round of primer coats, or I can just go start with some base colors, because the base colors are going to be brushed on, with the exception I might do the skin tones in the spray and then leave the rest, or I might do the white. Well, I don't know, we'll see. The skin tones is better if it's not brushed, because it gives it, I mean, once the clear coat goes on top, you're not going to be able to tell it it's been brushed on or sprayed on, so. But yeah, looking pretty good. All the little bits, clouds are starting to come in. It was like baking my brain earlier with the sun just like right on me, like bam. But yeah. Alright, this will probably conclude progress for today, a couple days. Let this primer completely dry. We used the 2X. Ultra covers the Rust-Oleum primer. But yeah, it's looking pretty good. It did fill in. Like I said, I'll sand all that flat and make it look more perfect. And then of course we'll go with the base color paints. But yeah, all right. Whoever's having a good center of the week, and we will see you soon.
Good morning, everybody. June 8th, 2023. Time to continue work on the Homer Simpson electric bass. The primer had time to settle overnight, and I'm getting ready to sand all the bits and make it smooth and perfect. And then we'll see, we'll probably let it sit another day, and then we can start with some base color paint coats. But yeah, the main sanding part is just going to be those sections that I explained the other day, and on the back, and make all these seam lines flat. So it should turn out pretty good. It's a pretty good primer. All right, I'll see you when I get all that done. See you in a bit.
All right, quick update. I filled in, actually did some more of a wood grain filler and let it filled in all the voids and sanded it smooth again. And I think we're ready for some base color paints. Trying to decide which paint to, I'll probably do a little bit of white, just the shirt parts in spray on and then brush everything else, because it's gonna be a pretty long and intense in depth brush job, but it's gonna look really cool. Alright, so let's start getting a little bit of white on there and we'll see in a little bit. I spray painted the white. Let me show you the back first. And it looks pretty awesome. And all the 2K clear coat will definitely hide any imperfections as far as texturing and everything like that, so pretty cool. Alright, we're gonna work on the pants bits first with the Maui Blue.
Maui blue.
So, all right, let me brush it on there. Let me show you how cool
I did the whites for the eyes, the teeth, and the shirt.
So, all right, so let's start working on the pants. First round of base coat colors. This is gonna be cool. All right, we'll see you in a bit. All right, very cool. Got the pants blue, first layer since. This is always my favorite part because you can see how the colors start to bring the shape to life. That is so cool. And I might go with silver, flat silver. You know, it's supposed to be gray for the boots, but I think silver would be pretty cool. We'll see how it looks though. But I guess now, next we'll go with some flesh tones. Let's get some yellow on there and see what happens. Let's see in a bit. All right, quick update. First layers of base coat paints have been applied, and that just oh wow, I tell you, color just it's just something you just don't see every day, you know. That's so very cool. I say that so much, but and of course I'll layer probably multiple layers left to go on most of the colors. I think the white should be good to go, and when the 2K clear coat, I'll layer it up so all these little imperfections in the finish will not show at all. Same thing with all the, you know, make sure I get all into the edges and the corners, and this is just the broad first layer of paint. So, and when, you know, I get the small, tiny, itty bitty brushes and all the little, you know, in the center lines, all exactly perfect. It looks amazing. But yeah, pretty nice day. It's kind of overcast, a little cloudy. Perfect day for painting Homer Simpson bases. So, yeah, and the mouth a little bit turned out really cool. Shadow of the 5 o'clock shadow he's got going on, and with the black and the tongue inside the mouth, that's so cool. All right, hope everybody's getting ready to have a good weekend. Thursday. All right, and I might put a couple more layers, but this will probably conclude progress today on the Homer Simpson electric base. And we'll see you soon. We'll get it dialed in. Can't wait to put the 2K clear coat over the top, because it's going to make everything just completely brilliant and glossy and perfect. And of course, with the eye, you know, the pupils, I'll get the really fine tip paintbrush and get all the way to the edges, so everything will look really cool. Alright. And we'll see you soon. Have a good one. Alright, one more quick update. We're inside the house, and I just wanted to show how cool it looked in this different lighting. Alright, first layers of base coat paints, as you know, have been applied. And I tell you, that blue really sets it off. That blue and the gray combination, that's just, that's awesome. And we'll let this dry for a day, and then we'll get out the fine tip brushes and do all the, you know, connecting all the little bits. But yeah. I think it turned out really cool. It's just so killer. Like I said, this is just the first round of paint, so got quite a few more layers till it's solid. Yeah, I love the tan 5 o'clock shadow bits. And of course, we're gonna have to, once we get the base complete, we'll have to get the Marge and the Homer together and play something magical. So, and then once we get the, continue working on the Maggie electric guitar, and I can't wait to get that one going, and then we'll have the whole family. We'll have Marge, we'll have Homer, have Maggie, and then we'll have Lisa and Bart. And we'll have all the intermediate family together. So that's cool. And I think I'm going to do a bass with the Greta. I'm gonna fix the inlay because I know it's stripe and not spike. We're gonna fix that, so that's gonna be cool. And then think about doing a Greta bass, so that's gonna be really cool. A bass guitar, but with the Greta Gremlin, and it's really cool. I've got a really cool design that I'm working on, and I'll have to share that with you. So that'd be really cool. And then this one's gonna be getting a custom case. I'm gonna be making that. I wanted it to, this is the double neck strat on the Fritz guitar. I wanted the paint to dry completely thorough. I mean, it was dry, but just want to make sure 100% it's dry, because once it goes in the case, I just want it to be perfect. But all right, so we'll continue progress on the Homer Simpson guitar, the bass guitar. That just, that color, that blue is just, wow. It completely matches, but all right, we'll talk to you soon. Good afternoon, everybody. It is June 10th, 2023, and as you can probably guess, we're continuing work on the Homer Simpson electric bass guitar, and I've come up with a cool font that I want to use for the inlay, and we're going to go ahead and get the Cricut machine out and apply it to the neck, and it's going to be a flat black inlay, so I like that. We'll see how it goes, and we'll see you in the next step. Alright, I'll see you in a little bit. Alright, got the Cricut machine out. I applied the clear tape, and I've got everything else taped off perfectly. Let's see if I can show you with the light. Yeah, there we go. Perfect. Alright. So let me go apply some paint, and fingers crossed it goes well. And I'll see you on the other side of that. We'll see you in a little bit. Alright, quick update. Successful application of the inlay. And that looks very cool. Perfecting the process of that. That looks pretty awesome. All right, so we're gonna let this sit for a day, dry pretty good. And then we'll apply the white base color paints to the front. And I may still do it to the back. And then reshape that lip on the top. And then get ready for prep it for paint for the glaze, which is going to be the pink, and then the donut color, which is going to be a tan or sand color for the donut, and then white on the top of the headstock, and then my logo in black right there, and then we'll be ready for some 2K clear coat and working on the body, getting all the base colors of paint perfected. But yeah, that looks pretty cool. It's going to be pretty awesome. The inlay turned out just awesome. All right, hope everybody's having a good weekend, and we will see you soon.
All right, see ya. Quick update, I was able to get all the fine tip brushes and get all the cracks, and this is that time to set for a day, so I'm getting ready to do a second round of base color paints. I just wanted to show you how it looked with the first color, or the first round of base color paints, with all the cracks filled in to the line exception, with a few exceptions. I got to get inside there by the neck joint because it was kind of a tight quarter there. But all right, we'll continue working on the paint. And with the inlay complete, and then we'll start continuing progress. But yeah, the mouth is looking really cool. I love the 3D bits of it. Very cool. Yeah, and see how the eyes got the full effect with the Alright, we'll see you soon. Alright, quick update on the Homer Simpson electric guitar build. I got the neck taped up. How I gonna paint some white on the front and the donut. And then I'll paint the donut the proper color with the glazing and the tan color for the donut. So alright, so let me go ahead and put some paint on here. I decided just to go with the white on the front. In the back, I think I can touch up the color of the wood grain and make it look perfect. So all right, we'll see you. Fingers crossed, get some paint on here, see you in a little bit.
All right, successful application of the white base coats on the front of the headstock and the donut bit. So I'm gonna show you, it turned out really cool. And of course the white on the donut's gonna be painted the tan donut color, and then the top part is gonna be the frosting. And then I'll add some white and darker red sprinkles. Theoretical sprinkles. But yeah, and all the texturing of the wood will be
hid by the multiple layers of base coats for that paint. So yeah, turned out pretty cool. Getting ever so closer. Oh yeah. Yeah, and I'm gonna touch up the back wood grain color on the shrinking of the tuning peg on the back to make it blend in perfectly. So, all right. Just a quick update for today. Continue this evening on furthering another round of base coats on the colors, and then we'll be good to go. All right, hope everyone's having a good week, beginning of the week, and we will see you soon. All right, quick update. Got the first layer of base color paints on the headstock and the donut, glazed donut bit. Yeah, Homer's definitely gonna be chasing after that donut. Yeah, it turned out pretty cool. And like I said, I'm gonna let this dry for a little while, and then I'm gonna add some sprinkles, some white and dark red sprinkles, and then of course my logo in black, and then 2K clear coat over the top of all that. And I might go with a darker shade for the donut because it does look fairly similar to the wood grain. But if you look up close, you can tell the difference. But I like it to be able to be seen from a distance, the different color. So I might go with a darker shade. But yeah, that is very cool. So, all right. And this probably conclude progress. All I'll do is, like I said, I'll do another layer of base coats on the body. But yeah, I think that turned out just like envisioned. Just like the that is so cool. All right. And we'll see you soon. All right, how's everybody doing? Just another quick update on the Homer Simpson electric bass guitar. All the bass colors of paint have been applied, and it is looking pretty sweet. Let me show you. Yeah, I'll let this dry for a few days, and then we'll go with the 2K clear coat. But I'll still do like a final touch up of all the colors to see how we are. But yeah, I think it turned out pretty sweet. All right, I hope everybody's having a good day. Let me get back up. Oh yeah. Looks pretty good. Awesome. And then let me show you. I painted the back access panel plate. And then as you recall, the neck with the donut. And I did go ahead and touch up all the... Let me show you that. Touch up the donut color paint. And it's pretty awesome. All right. Pretty cool. Looks good. And we'll let this cure for a few days actually. And then we'll go ahead and do some 2K clear coat over the front and then the donut. And then of course on the back access panel plate and then the complete body, but yeah. All right, we'll talk to you soon. Good morning, how's everybody doing on this fine beautiful day here in Central Florida? It's time to continue work on the Homer Simpson electric guitar bass. It is that time. It is time for some 2K clear coat. Got everything taped off the way I need, and we're gonna go ahead and put some layers of spray max 2K clear coat before the sun starts beating down on us. So all right, fingers crossed, we'll see you on the other side. Good morning, everybody. It is June 22nd, 2023. And as you can see, I am so excited. It is finally time to assemble the Homer Simpson electric bass. Got all the parts over there. Got all the tools and equipment I need. I applied some 2K clear coat a couple days ago. And as per usual, let me show you how that turned out. Let's see if I can grab this a certain way. There we go. Turned out really cool.
Everything is very shiny, very beautiful. That is awesome.
Very cool.
All right. So I get some good reflections.
Oh yeah.
Very cool. All
right. Oh, I've been waiting for this for a while now. This is going to be very cool.
So. Alright, first step I think this time, normally I start with the bridge, installing the, well I still might,
let me see how, because I've got the strings still attached, and the strings, when you put them on bases, you have to wrap around, so I'll probably do the bridge last. So first thing I'll probably do is install the input jack, well install the the pickup. So let me go ahead and mount the pickup, and then we'll start rolling. Yeah, it's gonna be very cool. I think the paint turned out just amazing. All right, we'll see you in a little while. All right, successful installation of the ground wire and the pickup, and then I've got the wires fished through the downward cavity. That's pretty cool. And like I said, I'll do the bridge last because it still had a string attached, so I'll do it right before I install the, after I install the neck, actually, that's when I'll install the bridge on this one. So, alright, so next step's going to be to configure the input jack and then, you know, get the wires and solder to that and then pull that through, and I'll see you when I get that done. See you in a little bit. Alright, successful installation of the input jack. Alright, we're going to go with a 250K ohm push-pull pot on this one. Coil split capability. So we're going to go ahead and pre-wire everything for this and wire up the tone knob as well, and we'll see when I get that done. Alright, see you in a bit. I got my push-pull pot pre-wired, and I think I've showed this before. That's with the pre-wiring and the ground on the side, and then I've got my tone knob pre-wired. Alright, so let me turn it over and let's get these wired together, and I'll see you in a little bit. Alright, got everything wired up. Hopefully everything is correct. So we'll see you in a second. Let me go ahead and install the pedometers to the body, and we'll see you in a bit. Alright, got everything pushed through. It's looking pretty good. Now it's time to do a full-on sound test. So let me get that set up, and then we're gonna, fingers crossed, hopefully everything went well. Alright, we'll see you in a little bit. Alright, ready for a full-on sound test. Got my hot lead as always. Plug it in. Ah, cool. Alright, so as per usual, let's go with the volume all the way down, as tradition. Tone all the way up. And coil, both coils, so we should get anything, which we don't. Great. Alright, so let's go with the volume all the way up, and we should get both coils. Alright. A strong magnet. Yeah, it's cool. Both coils. Let's split it and see what happens. Get nothing there. All right, get perfect. Got the pull pieces, nothing on the bottom. Just some artifact. So that's good. And let's check out the tone. Take the tone all the way off. Oh yeah. Muffled. Can you hear the difference? Awesome. Successful wiring, so this is gonna sound amazing. All right, so the next step is let me go hang this back on the rack, and then let's get the neck out, install the tuning keys and the string trees, and then we'll get these two together. Yeah, this looks pretty cool. Oh, real quick, let me put the volume and the tone knob on. I'll be right back. All right, very cool. Got them installed. That looks awesome. All right, pardon on my fingerprint, so I'll clean all that out before I do the photo shoot. That looks pretty good. All right, go hang this up and get the neck out. All right, I'll see you in a bit. All right, real quick, I went ahead and installed the back access panel plate on, and I elected not to put the clear coat over that, but I still think it looks pretty cool. All right, and we go hang it up and get the neck. We'll see you in a bit. All right, cleaned up all the non-essentials, got all the parts that I got left to put on, and I got the neck back out. I just wanted to show you, I applied 2K clear coat to the headstock, and it looks amazing. Sealed in the logo. See if I get some reflections. And then on the donut, looks pretty cool. And then I did shine the back of the neck like I said I was going to. So yeah, so let me install the tuning keys and we'll see where we are. We'll see in a little bit. Very cool.
I like that it's got a little, you know, it's got the texture, and it's a little bit, it's pretty sweet. Alright, I'll see you in a little bit.
Alright, got the tuners and the string tree installed, and I gotta say, it looks awesome.
Wow.
That is very cool. Very cool indeed. That is just amazing. Love that donut with the bite out of it. Wow. That is so cool.
All right. Let's set it over here as per tradition. Let's get the body out. And then we'll get these two together and see what happens.
I'll see you in a little bit. All right.
Let's get the neck attached to the body and I'll see you in a little bit. Looks very cool.
Alright, fingers crossed on this one. We'll see you in a little bit.
Alright, successful installation of the neck to the bridge. And it looks very cool.
Whew. Went on without a hitch. Very smooth, very steady, very awesome. That's a good sign.
Alright, so let me get the bridge out and put the strings on there for now. And then I'll see you when I get that done. But wow, that looks so cool. Look at that.
Very cool.
Awesome. Alright. We'll see you in a little bit.
Very cool. Fingers crossed on this one.
Alright, very cool. I got the strings on the guitar and everything looks like it's lining up beautifully perfect. So let me go ahead and put the strap buttons on and then we'll get this to pitch and then do a full-on sound demonstration. Wow. That is so cool. All right, whew. And then of course I'll clean up all my fingerprints and then do a full picture update, full photo album and everything. Wow, that looks cool. Wow, the paint just does. It's so cool. All right, let me put the strap buttons on, we'll be right back. All right, got the strap buttons in, they look pretty good, awesome. Now, one last step is to permanently anchor in the hair bits. So let me go ahead and install them in the holes there. Fingers crossed on this one and we'll see in a little bit. All right, successfully installed the hair bits. Whoo, that's kind of nerve-wracking because that glue is very unforgiving. Once you put it where you need to put it, you can't make any adjustments. So yeah, hopefully that'll stay put for a good long time. So very cool. A little bit of strands of hair here and there. All right, let me set this down for a second, take a little bit of a break, but wow. And then get a strings up the pitch and then go ahead and do a full-on sound demonstration. But wow, that looks so cool. I love everything about that is just so neat. Whew, that was a little bit stressful there, but we got through it. But
all right, we'll see you in a little bit. Let me get these strings up to pitch and then do a sound test. See you in a little bit.
Alright, got it dialed in. I got it intonated. It is sounding and playing.
Oh, it sounds so good too. That pickup is just amazing and it's got so many tonal qualities here. Check the roll off the tone. Thank you. I thought it'd be kind of cool to do a cover. Let's do a cover real quick. Check this out. See if you guys, anybody knows this one. Oh, you like my t-shirt, by the way? Let me find it on the internet real quick. See if I can remember. It's one of the songs we played back in the day. Hold on a second. Seven Mary Three, Cumbersome.
I found this for you.
I found this for you. Well, thank you, Cortana. There you go. Check this out. See if I can remember this one. It's been a while since I played these songs, but it's one of the ones we sang and I played. Oh yeah, forgot. Okay. Hold on, I'll play that one real quick, but let me tune up. Because actually the Go-Go's, they actually tune standard tuning, but they tune slightly down. So, I'll tell you what, we'll play that song another time. But let me go ahead and just do a few more demonstrations of the sounds. There we go. Yeah, the Go-Go is actually tuned to 440, but actually a couple cents lower than that. I think that helped Belinda Carlisle's voice, but... Thank you. coil split. This is with the coil split volume all the way up. Percussive, so you can do any kind of percussive, and no neck dive at all. It just hangs right where it's supposed to hang. Anyway, let this settle any way it needs to settle for the next couple days or so, and then I'll do a full, well, I'll probably do this before that. I'll do a full photo shoot and of course the up close and personal video. But yeah, I think it turned out really cool. And the colors are just, that donut is just something else. All right, hope everybody's having a good week. I know there's a lot going on in the world right now. It's pretty crazy, but get distracted. Kind of takes you away from all the craziness of the world. So, but yeah, I love the hair bits. It's so cool. And we'll see you continue working on the Maggie Simpson electric guitar. But yeah, very cool. Oh, this is a band called Dirty Denims, one of my favorite bands. Just a shout out to Mir Jam and all the people over there. I love you guys. You guys are the best. And if you have never heard of this band, you should really check them out. They are awesome. They've got some really great songs. YouTube them, the Dirty Denims. And shout out to you guys again, and we'll see you soon. All right, take it easy.